I just can't wait to introduce you all to my guest today. Let's say the goddess of Kathak dance form that is sitting with me right here on UVW, Archana Joglekar.
Pleasure to meet you. It's so wonderful to see you after so many years.
Yes,
and your same energetic, dynamic one.
So yes. I want to know right in the beginning, where were you born? How was it growing up? Let's just reminiscence.
I was born in the state of Maharashtra, in India, and in a city, Nagpur. So many people probably have this impression that I was born in Mumbai.
True.
Though I'm very much a Bombay product. But for the heck of it, I was born in Nagpur. And then for maybe 4 to 5 years after my birth, I mean, my family immediately shifted to Chandrapur, another smaller town place close to the Nagpur. Because my dad was in the central government service, and then he was shifting from one, you know, like department to another department. And he was working for the defense and army at that time. Mm. And he was located in Chandrapur at that time. And so we shifted to, literally after my birth, immediately we were shifted to Nagpur. So my nursery and KG happened in Chandrapur. That's where actually Archana Nrityalaya, now the Ivy League Academy, was founded in Chandrapur.
In Chandrapur.
By my mom. Yeah. And that was in 1963 when she founded it.
Wow.
And then we shifted to Mumbai.
Do you have any memories about Chandrapur? What was it like at all?
Oh yeah, many memories.
Really?
I mean, I was a toddler.
Yeah.
And but I was a menace. Even as a toddler,
no.
I was quite handful to my mom. Trust me, I was quite handful for my mom.
You don't look it.
I wish she was here to tell you that.
Oh, I know.
And then we had this, through the government in those times, you know, those who were the top ranking officers, they always used to get kind of a pune or the helping hand.
Yes, yes.
And he used to be available even in the domestic front. So there was this helping hand, because my dad used to be away from the home for Monday through Friday, and he used to come over only for weekends.
Achcha.
And my mom was the one who was handling both me and my elder brother.
So all those years ago, also those weekend husbands, huh?
Huh. So
he used to
come over. And then this guy who was kind of a, you know, helping hand, he used to take me and my brother, who was barely 1.5 years elder than me, to the school on a bicycle. And I used to be sitting in front of him, and my brother was sitting in behind him. And I was so like a dumb little thing, you know, keeping my legs in front of that, you know,
on the bike, handle,
that mudguard of the
mudguard.
And this guy, he used to drive the bicycle. And in those times, you know, the cycle rickshaws, you know, it was a cycle rickshaw, not an auto rickshaw.
Achha.
You know,
so
was cycle chalate the aur peeche baithne walo
ki, like. Seat,
so he had a couple of friends who were the cycle rickshaw wallas. And while, you know, taking us to the school, he used to just chit chat with the cycle rickshaw wala. And the cycle rickshaw wala, who was going parallel with him, he noticed at me, looked at me, and I mean, imagine how dumb I was sitting, that my leg went inside the cycle, inside the wheel of the cycle, and it was getting cut.
And you don't know?
The ankle was getting cut, and I didn't scream, I didn't yell, I didn't say anything. I'm just sitting there, and the blood is going down. And he was like, ah! It was like that.
Are you kidding me?
And it was like a spoon, this much, spoon shape of cut on the ankle. And then he was devastated, and he was scared that my mom obviously would.
But how come you were quiet?
I don't know, that's how I was. And then once I remember we had this enclosed colony, and I mean, after my ankle was wounded, I was I mean, obviously my mom rushed me to the doctor, and he did bandage and this and that. And then for many days I wouldn't walk. I would just, you know, drag my butt on the floor and you know, move from one room.
I can imagine. Yeah.
And I don't think it was that bad.
But how old were you? 2, 3?
2 or less than 2.
And you remember all this?
Yeah. And then one uncle who used to come to our home, he was a magician. He used to do all kinds of magics. And I was sitting in the kitchen, and he said, "Where is Archana?" And my mom said, "No, she is wounded, so she doesn't walk."
Uh-huh.
I said, "Why she doesn't walk?" She said, "Yeah, just she just feels that she can't stand on her feet. So jabki mera dusra paav sahi salamat tha. So he said, no, you're going to get up and you can walk here and see. Some candies or something. Or he said, I'll make this sound of bird and this and that. Uh-huh. And to see that, I just stood on my both the feet. Walked it. So how, as a kid, you know, one candy. Yeah. And then one fine day, my mom, because it was like, three buildings, you know, and a playground in between. And we had a nice entrance to the society where we were living. Uh-huh. And mom used to be assured that all the kids are playing down, you know. And one fine day in the evening when she was like, we were on the first floor and she wanted to just call us back home and she just didn't find me. And she said, where is she? You know, and I just walked out of that premise and with couple of little girls with me. And we just went on walking, God knows, up to marketplace, wherever. And then we were hungry, so we just pointed at some, you know, pehle zamane mein wo glass ki barnis mein toffees rakhte the dukan wale. So we just pointed at, so probably we were adorable cuties, probably. That we pointed at those candies.
And he gave it to you.
He opened and gave it. By then, there was havoc in the house and all the guys were searching. And finally, they came up to that dukan wala.
This is a story about a toddler?
Yes.
Archana, I'm going to be able to take care of your life in 1 hour. I don't think so.
So there were many interesting incidences.
But don't you?